Stage one of the Taliban's plan is complete. Expel foreign countries. Stage two is convincing those same foreign countries to recognize them. It's not an easy job. The first Taliban regime had little success with it. They sent envoys to world capitals. They dispatched officials to the United Nations. None of it worked. Only three nations recognized the Taliban: Pakistan, Saudi Arabia, and the United Arab Emirates. Three countries. This time, they've come with a plan. Tall promises and diplomatic flattery. Will the world fall for it? Well, depends on three factors. Number one, will the Taliban allow safe passage for foreign citizens and their allies? It's an early test of their promises. Number two, what will the government look like? Will it be inclusive? And will women be guaranteed equal rights and freedoms? Number three, the Taliban's commitment to battling terror, making sure the Al-Qaeda and ISIS Khorasan do not use Afghanistan as a staging ground. These three things are what the world will look for. And let's face it, number two and three look very unlikely: equality for women and crackdown on terror. But some countries don't really care. They can't wait to recognize the new rulers. And topping this list is Pakistan. Their double game has paid off. 20 years of covert support can now become official. The indications are already there. Trade between Afghanistan and Pakistan has increased 50%. This is despite multiple disruptions and border shutdowns. Then you have Shah Mahmood Qureshi doubling up as the Taliban's foreign minister. He has one message for anyone he meets: please talk to the Taliban, he says. Same with China. They were preparing for a Taliban takeover. All the infrastructure deals and loans are ready and printed. All they need is the Taliban's signature. China was always betting against the Afghan government, so why are they delaying the recognition? Well, here's what a Chinese spokesman said. It is a customary international practice that the recognition of a government comes after its formation. So China is playing on a technicality. Wait for a government before recognizing it. It's a question of when, not if. These are two solid Taliban partners, China and Pakistan. The rest of the world is circumspect. Some more than others, the likes of Russia and Iran, they're engaging with the Taliban. But they are in no hurry to recognize them. President Vladimir Putin is taking the measure of the Taliban. His concerns are not democracy or women's rights, for that matter. His concern is security. Order in Afghanistan means peace in Central Asia. That's all that Putin wants. A top Russian official has ruled out military ties with the Taliban. Clearly, Moscow sees this from a security angle only, not as a trade opportunity or an alliance. Iran is quite the opposite. They see security benefits. They also see a chance to make some money. Supreme Leader Ayatollah Ali Khamenei has said that Iran would back Afghans irrespective of who is in power. Now, traditionally, these are rival groups, because Iran is a Shia country, remember. The Taliban are Sunni. But they can unite behind a common enemy, the Western powers led by the United States. Plus, it's a new market for Iranian oil. The Taliban do not care about U.S. sanctions. They started buying Iranian oil 2 weeks back. It's a win-win for both sides. Much needed oil for Afghanistan, and for Iran, a hungry buyer right next door. It works well. These countries have reasons to recognize the Taliban, either money or security or deep state politics. What about Western countries? They don't share borders, but they share the responsibility for this mess. The United States says they're in no rush. They will wait for the Taliban's actions, not their words. The White House says that all American allies are on the same page. They will not hurry to recognize the Taliban.
I think it should be really clear here. There's no rush to recognition of any sort by the United States or any international partners we have talked to.
But here's the problem. The West recognizes the terror threat in Afghanistan. They need the Taliban to fight the ISIS Khorasan. So the question is, does recognition really matter? Would the Taliban prefer a U.S. embassy or U.S. funding? Would they want a seat at UNESCO or unlimited aid? It's a no-brainer. You cannot talk to the Taliban, seek their help in the battlefield, and then say, we don't recognize them. As long as money and weapons flow, the Taliban will not mind. Then why are they sweet-talking the world? Probably for optics. Diplomatic recognition fits well with Taliban 2.0. Zooming into New York for the United Nations or a joint meeting at Brussels works very well. For leaders who lived in the wilderness for 20 years, recognition is important, especially in the Islamic world. Turkey and Qatar are already close to the Taliban. They're in talks to run the Kabul airport. The rest of them are waiting for the US, the likes of Saudi Arabia and the UAE. Their decision will depend on which way Joe Biden goes, which brings us to the difficult question. Who will stand up to the Taliban? Right now, it seems like nobody will. The West is worried about terrorism. The neighbors are worried about security. The only ones who can mess up this status quo are the Taliban themselves. And things are going in that direction. We're seeing public executions, trials without evidence, strict laws for women, and revenge attacks on Western allies. If this continues, the world will lose patience, and hopefully it won't be too late. WION is now available in your country. Download the app now and get all the news on the move.